I think we just found one of the rarest reptiles on this planet. We can see it from here. He's hiding. Hello, my name is Michael, and today we finally managed to find the puzzle guardian lizard. These lizards are harmless, but quite magical. They usually hide and protect unique puzzle boxes. And this one in particular is protecting a beautiful box. Let's try to catch this little guy and see what he's hiding. Okay, we got him. Oh, wow. This is a beautiful box. Look at that. What's up, Puzzleverse? And welcome back. Today, we are going to attempt to solve a puzzle that received a jury honorable mention at the last IPP puzzle design competition. We already solved a puzzle from this designer. Here's a little clue. He likes to torture his family with puzzles during Christmas. Yes, I am talking about Joseph G. Turner. And his latest puzzle creation is called 3Me8, also known as the Reptile Box. It's a sequential discovery puzzle box, which looks absolutely spectacular. By the way, I hope you did enjoy this intro. If you did, don't forget to put a like to this video. And do not worry, no lizards were harmed during this video. So, let's get into it. And here it is, the 3Me8 puzzle, aka the reptile box. Look at it, this box looks so beautiful. I love the choice of each color. It makes this box just amazing. And look at it for a few seconds. This box is marvelous. The work involved in making this puzzle is amazing. So, that's our puzzle box, and there are few instructions that comes with it, and also a solution book in case you get stuck during the solve of this puzzle. We have this first card with the goal and the instructions to solve the puzzle. The goal is to open the reptile box and free the coin. And you can see the coin at the bottom of this puzzle. That's amazing as well. You have a US dollar coin and the signature and the name of Joseph G. Turner. That's really, really cool. And the instructions are: everything needed to solve the puzzle is provided. No excessive force needed, no banging, spinning, gravity, or burning required. That's the unique rule of Joseph G. Turner. I think he makes this kind of joke because it's during Christmas and you might be tempted to throw the puzzle into a fireplace. And then there is one more note, quite important during the solve of this puzzle. Small reptiles are decorative only and are not related to the solution. Do not pull or twist them or you may break them off. And that is an important note to know because you might break your box, which would be very sad to be honest. So it is time to inspect the box and check what can we do. On the top of the box, you have three big lizards and two smaller ones, which we will not touch, obviously. Then at the front, nothing. On the right side, nothing. On the back of the puzzle, you have this hinge and a screw. Maybe we will have to unscrew it. We will see that later. On the left side of the box, nothing. And at the bottom of the box, you have your American coin. So nothing special. The first thing that I will think to do is to try to remove maybe one lizard, maybe more. So we will try to be careful and see if they are moving. This one is moving. Yeah, I can remove this one. Need to be careful. I don't want to break such a beautiful box. And look at this lizard. It was attached to the box with a magnet. That's really nice. Really cool. So we have our first tool, a magnet, quite unique one, to be honest. Can we move the other ones? This one moves. And this one? This one is stuck. Yeah. So if this one moves, then I can remove it. A bit harder to remove. Okay. Oh, a pin. That's interesting. A second tool. It's really cool, but this puzzle box has such a great theme. Now, what can we do? Well, with a pin, I don't think we can do much for now. I cannot see inside the hole. Since we have a magnet, it is time to inspect the box with this magnet and see what can we find. Okay, so the small lizard has something metallic inside. Maybe it's just to attach it. This big one has something metallic as well. But oh, it kind of moves. Can you remove it? No, not really. It's quite stuck. Maybe later it will slide or something. That will be cool. But yeah, nothing for now. This one also might be attached with a screw maybe to the box. So nothing to do. Then, did you hear that? There's something here. Ooh, it's like a clip. Or a button. Wait, maybe that? Give me access to move that. Look! It slides! Wait. Okay, so we can slide this one. We need to be quite careful. I wonder if it's connected. Let's see. No, it is not connected. Okay, so we can slide this one. The box is still closed. And then there is something here. I don't know what it is. Okay, let's move on. Oh, there is something else here. So on the front of a box, we have two areas where you can use a magnet. Okay, on the side. Oh, there is something here. But it repulses the magnet. Okay. Maybe we can move something. Interesting. Wait, I'm really curious to know what is the mechanism inside of a box. Okay, so the hinge are magnetic, obviously. The screw is not. Then, nothing on this side. And at the bottom, nothing. So we have three places that we can play with. This one. Maybe let's move something here. And here. Yes. Just here. It also repulses the magnet. It's quite confusing. What to do? Yeah, it's quite strong. I don't know if I'm moving something. I'm thinking maybe there is a lock that is inside something. And then maybe you need to push it to remove a lock and maybe to gain access to something else. Maybe you need to play with orientation of a box as well. No, nothing's happening, right? That's such a cool puzzle. You don't see what is happening inside. So you have to really be imaginative about what is inside. What you need to do. We are really in this state of discovery and try to figure out what to do. What will you do? I wonder if some of them are connected. Maybe you need to move this one first and then you can push this one in this direction. So it keeps both of them open. I don't know what to do with this side. I can feel whatever it is, it's moving. It's not moving up and down like this. but it's moving around. I wonder if there is something to do with this lizard here. Oh, and maybe if I move it. Okay, that's amazing. And if I remove it. Oh. I can see something in the hole. Okay, I could see that the hole, well, goes down inside the box. But now, there is like a white or metallic thing blocking it. That's really amazing. That's so crazy. You need to use the two lizards. That's really interesting. There is a big pin or something, a lock maybe, that travels from here to here. And you can repulse it with a lizard. So you can put on this side or on this side. I don't know which one. So I put it in this side right now. And my goal would be maybe to attract this one and maybe make it fall. There's a noise. Oh, I can move something. Okay, we open it. That's so crazy. Wait, I need to find out what happened. But I'm so sure that we have a big lock traveling from here to here. Let's find out what is inside the box. What? Nothing! Wait! What? It's not finished, but I don't understand it. We need to find out. Okay, from here, you can see a pin. Now, yes, I can attract the pin. Oh, I can move it. So that's what I could feel here. But I'm missing something. That is here. And you cannot see. Not yet, maybe. Wait, that's amazing. There's another little lizard. That's crazy. I love this box so much. Wait, okay, so the lizard doesn't move, but we still have this. We can slide this one just a bit to push this like this. That's amazing. Okay, then there must be other things to do. I feel there are two coins, which is amazing. Yes, there are two coins. Okay, so we need move. Oh, you can see there is a first panel here, but there is a second one behind it. You can see move it like this. Oh, okay. I'm discovering how the box works at the same time. You have this metallic pin here, and I think you can see it, I hope, but there is another metallic pin, which is the lock that gets into this part, just here. Now, if I attract this pin and move it down, I can unlock this pin here and then open the box. That's amazing, right? Okay, so that's how we manage to open the box. Now I remember that we can repulse something here, and maybe that's part of the solution. Okay, let's put back this thing here. Then let's move that. Yeah. Oh, wait. I can just pull it. Wow, wait. I can pull it to remove this and get one coin. And maybe two. No. That's so tricky. That's so many things are happening. But we have our first half dollar coin. And that's amazing. So now, what can we do? Well, yeah, we need to remove a second panel on this side. And I think that's why we could feel a lock here. We need to push the lock somewhere. And maybe that's the lock for this panel. I'm not sure what to do, but I do think that, yes, the magnet here needs to be in a very specific position to remove this panel. I don't know if the two locks are connected. Maybe they are, which would be amazing. Okay, I did it. I opened it a bit. I think it's enough. So what I did is just lock this one at the line. So it's not completely off like it used to be. I can remove this one a bit. And now, yes, now I think I do have access to this compartment. I can remove this wooden tray like this. I can do it. Yes. And I can access the last half dollar coin. Yes. That's amazing. Wow. First, you think that you have just to release one coin, but there are two. That's so cool. That's so cool. And all these lizards around makes this puzzle so enjoyable. That was so crazy. Wow. What a cool puzzle box. I loved it so much. So now it is time to put it back together. I think I did understand the mechanisms inside and we can go through it so you understand it as well. So we put back our coin, we put back this thing. Now we should be able to put this part down. And for that, there is a magnet here. You should be able to push to put it back. And you can only push this one up or down if you play with a magnet first, but also if this one is showing just the line. And that's a really tricky mechanism. So you have this, and now the next step is to put this one up to be able to put back the coin and this wooden tray. So you play with a magnet that is here, you can release the pin and put this wooden part up, which gives enough space first to put back the coin, but then to put this one back inside. Like this, you align with the coin, you push it a bit so it gives the illusion that you get access to your last coin, but you don't. And then you can push this one back in place. And now you can close the box. And for that, you need to make sure that this lock is released. So you can remove a lock. Now you should be able to close the box like this. You put back the lock. So the box is once again locked and you need to block the lock with this part here. That's really nice. So you put the lizard down, then you can just put the box like this and it will just, with the gravity, go down. And now you cannot open the box anymore. It's totally sealed. That's amazing. And that's so crazy that you have one pin here that is blocking the access to the lock here. They're connected, which is amazing. Now you can put this lizard here to hide this mechanism, and to finish, you put back this little lizard here in place. So you put the box back to its original condition. That was amazing. And I can say that I solved a reptile box by Joseph G. Turner. That was an amazing puzzle. I loved the solve of this puzzle box. And you, what did you think about this puzzle? Did you enjoy it? What was your favorite moment? Please, let me know in the comments below. If you did enjoy this video, you did enjoy the intro and the puzzle, don't forget to put a like on this video and to subscribe to the channel for more amazing puzzles. I see you next week for a new video. Tschüss! This little guy gave us an amazing puzzle box. It's time to put it back to its natural environment.